Morning, friends and everyone. This is Ilyas. So I said good morning. It is good evening wherever in the part of the world. Yesterday, I thought of make this video on Tablighi Jamaat issue that's going on in India, Nizamuddin location. I watched a couple of videos. That is Barkadat from Mozo TV and Shankar Gupta from the print Indian Express. I mean, I used to follow them when I was in India. And then Professor K. Nagesar of a genius, wonderful man from Hyderabad. And I also watched the other news also, right? Before I start, what I understand, let me see what they told in brief, very brief. So Barkadat is doing wonderful job, ground reporting from the ground, from Mozo TV, I think. The topic is Tablighi Jamaat and physical distinction in US, physical distancing. It's not just social distancing. Physical distancing is not 6 feet between two people. $1,000 is the fine in Michigan, is the governor told. So whatever governor say, people follow it. So like that in India also, Delhi CM would have been given an orders, and the Prime Minister office or Prime Minister is responsible for allowing foreigners to come, right? When the COVID-19 issue is going on, the Foreign National Affairs Minister or people who issued visas, they are responsible. Okay, will come one after another. Congregation means it's a group of people sitting together, like close proximity, right? It's all about congregation versus COVID-19 and superstition, right? And Barkadat, what she reported is okay. And now comes to the Shankar Gupta. He gave an example in South Korea, churches started this and from there. And then he quoted a 23 minutes long video. That's fine. I talked about the Punjabi man from Punjab went to Italy, Germany, various countries, and he also brought the virus to India. Congregation, he met thousands of people. That is one. And Indian professor from Telangana, K. Nagesar, is heads of putting videos in Telugu. So since I know the Telugu, so I watched it. So he also find fault with Tablighi Jamaat and Delhi and central government. That's good. And also he received threats from the Muslim community in Hyderabad, is what he kept a video. And the coming festivals, Hajj and then Olympics, Iran and Buddhist, India holy function, holy festival also celebrated. And superstition and religions are two sides of the coin. Oh, I'm not telling my points, whatever they told, I'm just briefing it to my subscribers, viewers, or because I follow some of them, right? I mean, most of them. Catholic Church, Easter and Ramjan. Up to this, in 3 minutes, I told exactly what I watched, 23 minutes video and 10 minutes, 20 minutes and another 20 minutes. Whatever I watched, 40 minutes of their three people on the news, I put it in 4 minutes. Let me come with my analysis. I may take coffee on and off in between. See, don't add fuel to the fire. That means already India is burning with COVID-19 and so many economic and other issues. So when you pick up Muslim or Islam in one particular, that's not good. See, I'm not advising them because I'm not, who am I first of all? I'm not tall enough. But whatever I watched, or if I were a journalist, what I would do is what I'm trying to. In USA, governor issues the orders. For example, some schools, they want to continue the school. But once the governor issues the order, everybody shut their mouth and follow the instructions. Something like that people have to follow in India. Nobody goes out here once they say don't go out. So people coming from 190 nations, they follow the law. people may go exceptional one or two cases, right? So that is something people have to do in India, because they lost trust in the government, police, public, whatever. And police beating public also won't kill the COVID-19, right? If I were you, or if I were a journalist or international journalism or some standards, first I go to temples in India, because TTD, the staff itself is 13,500 when I worked in 1997. Now it will be 20,000 employees, right? More. They all live in one place or close proximity, and 80,000 people visit temple on an average given day. And what about them? So don't think that they're all from India. So many NRIs from non-resident Indians, or whatever you, some they call non-reliable Indian. They live in various nations in the globe, and they also visit temples, right? So they don't need any, what do you call, visas, because they're visiting India, right? They might have visited so many temples across India, not just TTD, Tirupati. Any temple in every state, we have famous temples, and then crowd-pulling temples, visa temples, right? US visa temples. There are 12 US visa temples. Have you visited? Have you asked any of the priests there how many are coming locally and from internationally? So that first point I would do, or you should do, whatever. Second, I would go to all churches, major churches. Some people send videos, I don't know what's up, majority 90% fake. When it is recorded, we don't know, right? Who recorded? So all the churches are closed or not? Because in US, all Hindu temples are closed. Closed for public, I mean. It's not that complete shutdown. Something like that, India, everybody has to follow. There is no exception, because they are killing others, right, with the virus. Then you go to Tablighi Jamaat, or whatever, Jamaat, Tablighi, whatever you call. That is where Indian media, Indian journalists are going to fail and adding fuel to the fire. So these are all the places, like Simhachalam in Vizag, Vijayawada. Because I am from Telugu states, I am speaking it. Otherwise in Adilabad there are temples, crowd pulling temples, right? The same way Orissa, Madhya Pradesh, so many states, Bihar. So have you been to those temples? Have you counted how many people visited from COVID-19 affected countries? No, right? Yes, you would have shown those videos first. Then churches. How many churches have you visited? Then Islamic places, right? Tablighi Jamaat. Again, I'm not adding because somebody did crime. I don't like to add it to the entire community, like one caste, religion or country. Individual is individual, right? And who asked them, who gave permissions to them to conduct the meeting next to police station? So the police station and then Delhi chief minister is responsible. Whoever gave visas, external affairs minister fault, and overall the head, the prime minister, and before that home minister, they all have to resign for their blunder. They are playing with the lives of the people. Don't show your finger at Tablighi Jamaat, or sorry if I pronounce wrongly, Tablighi Jamaat. I would appreciate if you go to all temples, all churches, then Tablighi Jamaat. Then whoever did wrong, then you ban it. You arrest them. But don't go directly to make your views and news highlighted to one particular religion, especially countries like in India. You have to sensitive countries, right? You cannot make your news famous by pointing one religion. That is where I'm going the other way around. Or at least we should have some standard when we report, right? So we failed to identify the problem, or doing root cause analysis, and then we're directly pointing out there. That is where I thought of communicate these points. Thank you for watching.